Northeast Youth and Family Services is a lifeline to over 4,000 youth and families every year. They work with people to help them overcome obstacles today while building skills that will transform their lives tomorrow. Whether it's a youth charged with status offenses such as theft or drug abuse, or a young lady like Kennedy, who developed RED due to being abandoned on the street and time spent in an orphanage, NYFS is dedicated to bringing about hope, one person and one family at a time.
What I love the most about my job is working with families and helping them communicate more effectively and handle conflict in an easier way. I think Kennedy and her parents are really a great example of how that can happen.
I am diagnosed with reactive attachment disorder. I was neglected in the orphanage, so I didn't exactly have the care that I needed that most kids would get while they're like toddlers and babies.
Reactive attachment disorder is a lifelong mental illness. At the age of two, the window kind of closes on your brain being wired for trust and cannot be reversed. So my husband and I wanted to start a family, and we had a Kenyan American friend who directed us to Kenya for adoption. The first time we met Kennedy was at her orphanage.
We knew something, you know, wasn't right. She seemed to connect with everybody except for us. And it seemed like the more love we gave her, the more she pushed us away.
I remember the fighting used to be so bad with my family that it'd just go from like a 0 to a 10 very quickly. I remember saying things that I regret.
She did not want to be helped. She wanted to do everything on her own. It was also affecting her younger brother in negative ways, and there was property destruction and sometimes physical volatility.
When I first started coming to NYFS, I wasn't exactly too happy about it.
The first time that I met Kennedy, it was 2013. It was her first day here at NETS. She was really quiet. She didn't really want to speak out in group too much or interact with her peers a whole lot, but I could tell she still wanted to connect with people.
In her last few family sessions, both with her mom and her dad, she would share much more easily about how she was feeling and what she was thinking.
She started building her relationships with the staff. She started doing special things for them for their birthdays and things like that, and a lot of those skills started to carry over with her peers.
The staff here were really nice and caring, and they cared about my family and me, and it was really fun to be around them. I kind of want to come back.
The people were very approachable. The interview was very comfortable and just made us feel at home.
It wasn't like regular therapy where you have a sit-down conversation and it is very serious. It was more like you could let your emotions out and they would be okay with it.
The greatest thing that NETS did for Kennedy was to help her express her emotions and let people know what she was feeling in a healthy way.
And once she started here, she started learning some strategies. They clicked when she was at NETS, and she was able to generalize them into her home life.
We've seen a huge change in Kennedy with her fitting in with our family and being able to express her feelings.
She became a leader with her peers. She was just developing into a young woman, and it was beautiful to see.
Because of Kennedy's time at NETS, I really believe that she learned very important coping skills for her future. She is now a straight-A student in her first year in high school and has come a long, long way academically and just behaviorally. Her future is very bright, and I know she wants to be an architect, so sky's the limit.
If this intervention hadn't happened, I think she would have struggled more at school. She had started to have suspensions and struggles with teachers, and I think it would have gotten worse.
I'm most grateful for the NETS program because it gave us our daughter back.
I am so lucky to have my mom, my dad, and my brother. If you have kids that are struggling and they need help, I recommend this place because these people are caring, they're kind, they're loving, and they're fun to be around.
Transforming lives is the mission of Northeast Youth and Family Services. Kennedy's story is an excellent example of one life transformed by renewed hope for the future through the support, resources, and services of NYFS. These success stories are the building blocks and cornerstones of our commitment to educate and prepare youth, adults, and families in life skills and to become active members in our community. It takes time, people, and money to provide the counseling, health education, and support services needed to bring about renewed hope and change in profound and lasting ways.
With your help, more people will find the best in themselves.
Your donations make it possible for our youth, like Kennedy, and families to have a better future and succeed in ways they never imagined.
Make a difference in someone's life today.
You may never know which doors you open for our young people and families, but they know.
It's time. The need has never been greater. Donate now.